Wonderful stars of summer. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Marlene Hidalgo, science teacher from Miami-Dade County, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
This week is the first week of summer for the Northern Hemisphere.
Yes, but it doesn't really get dark out until almost 10 p.m. for those of you at more northerly latitudes. This means that many of you will have to stay up a little later to do your summer stargazing.
Ah, but the summer stars are worth it. Let's show you. Okay, we've got our sky set up for 10 p.m. this week facing north, where you'll see the Little Dipper at its very highest above the North Star. In fact, the North Star is the star in the end of the handle of the Little Dipper.
Now, the Little Dipper is not nearly as large or as bright as the Big Dipper, which is directly to its left in the northwest. Four stars mark its cup, and three stars mark its handle. And once you've found it, you can shoot an arrow through its handle to find the fourth brightest star in the sky, Arcturus.
Arcturus is the brightest star in the constellation Boötes the Herdsman. And although the entire constellation looks more like a kite, I like to think of it as an ice cream cone. You can extend the arrow from the Big Dipper's handle through Arcturus and over to the brightest star in Virgo, Spica. Remember, arc to Arcturus and speed on to Spica.
Now, we can tell from the stars that spring is almost over because spring's most famous constellation is just above the western horizon. A backward question mark of stars marks the front part of Leo the Lion, and a triangle of stars marks his rear. And he looks like he's getting ready to plunge below the horizon before summer kicks him out of the evening skies.
Next, if you turn around and face east, you can see three bright stars which mark the summer triangle: Vega, Altair, and Deneb. And every summer in mid-June, we always see this triangle of three celestial dazzlers rising over the eastern horizon.
Of course, my personal favorite stars of summer are toward the south. So by looking southward, you can't help but spot the giant fishhook-shaped pattern of stars, which is none other than summer's infamous Scorpius the Scorpion.
It's one of the few constellations which actually looks like its name. It even has a red star where its heart should be, named Antares. This is a humongous star, 700 times wider than our own million-mile-wide sun.
And if you follow the stars down from Scorpius' heart star, you will see how his rather nasty tail curves up and then back on itself, just like a real scorpion's tail, with two stars marking its poisonous stinger. Their Arabic names from left to right are Shaula and Laseth, and these names mean the sting.
Just to the left of the scorpion stinger, you'll find the eight bright stars that mark the asterism of the teapot. Nestled within Sagittarius the Centaur Archer, the teapot is easy to find. Draw lines between these three stars to form the spout, these three stars to form the lid, these four stars to form the handle, and these four stars to mark the body.
And if you observe this part of the sky from a very dark location, you'll see the faint glow of the Milky Way, a cloudy band of millions of stars appearing to arc across the night sky. With a little imagination, you can envision the Milky Way as steam coming out of the teapot.
And if you want to get really sporty, watch the night sky for a few hours and sing the familiar teapot song. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout. Tip me over and pour me out. As the Earth slowly rotates from west to east, the stars rise in the east and set in the west, giving the appearance that the teapot is tipping over to pour tea on the tail of Scorpius the Scorpion. Neat, huh?
So there you have it. Any direction you look, you'll see wonderful stars during the first nights of summer.
Keep looking up. Looking up.